This is With Rage, a Maeve Sharp mystery, book 4, written by Rylie Dark, read by Caroline. Prologue. Emily woke up to the worst headache of her entire life. She blinked her eyes open, waiting for the world to come into focus. Clothes were strewn across the floor like confetti, empty champagne glasses littered the ground, and half-spilled drinks adorned every available surface. Emily groaned and brought a hand to her throbbing head. She blinked away the remnants of sleep and tried to remember what happened the night before. Emily groaned, her hand instinctively moving to her temple, in an attempt to alleviate the pounding in her head. As her eyes gradually adjusted to the light, fragmented memories began to piece themselves together, like a jigsaw puzzle. The flashing lights of the nightclub, the bachelorette party, her fellow bridesmaids' sequined dresses. Las Vegas. Emily had been excited for her best friend Grace's final fling before the wedding. She remembered the laughter, the clinking of glasses, strutting down the main street in mini dresses, wearing plastic tiaras. But it was turning out to be a lot more partying than she expected. Flashes of scenes played in her mind's eye. Dancing, laughter, the vibrant lights of the Vegas Strip. Yet the details remained frustratingly elusive. She was certain she had enjoyed herself. Yet a nagging unease gnawed at her, clouding her memories like mist. Dragging herself out of bed, Emily squinted at her phone on the nightstand, half buried beneath a pile of bejeweled clutches and makeup compacts. She unlocked it with a shaky hand, her fingers hovering over the screen. Her photo gallery was filled with blurry snapshots of the previous night, smiling faces, exuberant poses, the glitzy allure of the city. Despite the dull ache in her head, she felt a sense of happiness. Grace spent her last few nights as a free woman, enjoying herself with her best friends. Who could ask for more than that? Emily tried to remember the places that she had gone to and the people she had met. She hoped that she hadn't done anything too embarrassing or that she had enough money left in her purse for the cab ride to the airport. She put her phone down, satisfied that she would probably never remember everything that happened that night, and she shrugged it off. Wasn't that the point of going to Vegas? She pushed herself out of bed. As the early morning light filtered through the curtains of the hotel room, it revealed scenes of dishevelled chaos. In the midst of the scattered debris, the four other bridesmaids, Kenzie, Beth, Haley, and Callie, were passed out on the floor just like she had been. Some of them had made it to their designated bed or the couch. A few collapsed on the ground. Emily smiled and took a picture. This would be funny later. Kenzie emerged with a dishevelled expression, tousled hair, and makeup that had seen better days. Her hair, usually meticulously styled, resembled a wild tangle of golden threads, and her eyeliner had taken on a life of its own, as though it was trying to escape off the side of her face. "I need about a gallon of coffee," Kenzie complained. Beside them, Beth emerged from the crumpled sheets with a yawn, her once neat bun now a mess of dark waves. The remnants of glitter on her face gave her an almost ethereal appearance, as if she had been part of a midnight celebration with the stars themselves. It was a sight to behold, each woman in some random combination of sequined miniskirts, pajama tops and stockings. The laughter, cheers and exuberant toasts from the night before were now met with bleary eyes and muttered regrets. There was an unspoken camaraderie. Emily imagined them all laughing about this in 10 years. When they were richer and could look back on their reckless weekend in Vegas. At least no one got hurt. As the bridesmaids exchanged knowing glances and offered sympathetic smiles, a sense of determination began to dawn. "Oh my God," said Kenzie. "Grace went too hard last night. Is she even here?" "I don't know. Did you see that bartender making eyes at her? And with the ring she has too?" "She did so many shots, I'm not sure she remembered her own name, much less that she was engaged," whined Beth. Emily ignored the comments and searched for her best friend, piled under all of the strewn clothes and purses, and a mysterious feather boa that she didn't remember buying. "Grace," said Haley, "maybe if this marriage doesn't work out, you can marry that guy." "He was hot," agreed Kenzie. Worried lines etched Emily's forehead as she moved across the hotel room, navigating through the remnants of the bachelorette party aftermath. She finally spotted the bride, Grace, lying on the floor beside the bed, her limbs tangled in the bedsheets. A wave of relief washed over Emily. The others were only teasing. They'd forgive Grace.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.